ancient Korean martial art of Tae Kwon was developed about 1300 years ago. In modern times, its spectacular flying kicks have been incorporated in the art of Tae Kwon Do. Translated, it means art of the foot and the hand, and as a form of self-defense, has become widely accepted throughout the Orient as well as the West. Weekend magazine reporter Rick Teague has been an exponent of Tae Kwon Do for several years. In this report, he looks at the man regarded as the father of Australian Tae Kwon Do and at why the art has become so popular.
Airports are a familiar sight to the master instructor, Mr. Chong Chul Rhee. As president of Rhee International Taekwondo, he's based in Sydney but spends more than a third of each year travelling the length and breadth of Australia and New Zealand, overseeing what's become one of the largest martial arts schools in the world. Under his direct control is an organisation with well over 10,000 members training in more than 200 centres throughout the country. With military precision, these beginners or white belts parade before the master. Under qualified black belt instructors, they've spent the past few months learning the important basic techniques, the foundation on which they'll build their art. A former instructor in the South Korean Marine Commandos, Mr. Rhee was one of the elite corps of post-war Taekwondo instructors who in the 60s took the martial art beyond Korea's shores. In 1.5 decades in Australia, he has nurtured his brand of the art. His dedication to its promotion and well-being has stimulated massive interest for a variety of reasons, but primarily because of its effectiveness as a form of self-defense. Where it probably differs from other martial arts is the use of dynamic high kicks and what are termed flying kicks. These allow the exponent to cover considerable heights and distances, especially when dealing with more than one opponent. For training purposes, each deadly blow is fully controlled and stops a short distance from the target.
Doesn't need any experience, and for any age, or man or woman, can learn the art of Rhee Tae Kwon Do. I think some of them they will learn as a physical exercise, some just mental behind, perseverance, self-control, inner middle spirit, and the discipline. I think discipline is very important for any part of society.
What about as a self-defense method? Do you see it as being warranted in a place like Australia?
Yes, not before, but these days I think more people are looking for self-defense because of the world changing.
What do you see as the qualities engendered in students, apart from the physical aspects of the art?
School children learn the art of Rhee Tae Kwon Do. They can concentrate more on their studies, and they can be serious students at the school, and also serious children at home.
Students usually enroll from the age of 8 onwards. Through expert instructors, they're carefully guided through the fundamental movements and stretching exercises. As time passes and they become more proficient, they graduate to the more demanding techniques. At the same time, it's said, they'll build up self-confidence and self-discipline. Lots of preparation goes into developing the ability to stretch the body to achieve the maximum kicking height. In much the same way as the ballet student uses the bar, these young martial artists work on their performance. The reasons why they do it vary.
It's good to know you can walk around safe, and that it's good to know you're fit, you know, it feels good.
I want to keep fit and know know a little bit more where to keep your strength and that, and more discipline.
What about self-defense? Have you ever needed to use it?
Oh, no, but it's there if you want it. If somebody goes picks you up on the street, it's always there.
Fitness is the best thing, fitness.
What about self-defense?
Yeah, that's excellent, because just say if you get in a fight with other kids in school, you could defend yourself.
You think it's good?
Yes.
Is it hard to do?
No.
You find it easy.
Junior, fighting front. Chao did it. No!
Age has very little bearing on the standard of performance, as these two young exponents demonstrate. But for them to reach this level of expertise has taken dedicated self-effort under strict supervision over a couple of years. With a wider acceptance of this martial art in Australia, more families too are becoming involved. Apart from them attaining the obvious benefit of a sound knowledge in self-defence, many parents feel that they and their children receive a lot more from the art.
It teaches us not to be quitters, it teaches us to endure, it teaches us to follow things through and not be quitters. And of course, we train together, we enjoy these activities together, and we grow together and in a family bond.
Do you find that too?
Definitely, yes. And the self-discipline that the children have, because they're forced into discipline in various areas, but this is a self-discipline that they've learned. That's terrific, and a help for me as a mother, and as myself too, because I thought I was disciplined, but I wasn't till I started.
One, two.
The Rhee Taekwondo students are divided into 10 grades, which lead up to black belt status. Each is personally tested by the master instructor before proceeding to a higher grade, which is indicated by the colour of the belt. The highlight of any grading test is the examination of students going for black belts or higher degrees. Each grade has what is called a pattern, which consists of a set series of movements built around an unseen opponent. At this advanced stage, the student knows off by heart more than 250 set movements. There is also a test of the exponent's skill at sparring. This gives the individual a chance to match his or her repertoire of kicks and hand movements against a person of equal or greater skill. The test of power and technique comes in this form, when students break boards or tiles. This breaking, or destruction as it's called, proves popular with the crowd. Through these examinations, Mr. Rhee can closely monitor the general standard of performance. Those who pass these tests are personally presented with their black belts from the master. For those receiving their first degree or Dan, it's the result of no less than 3 years of concentrated effort, involving in the latter stages 3 or 4 training sessions a week, as well as practice at home. Opponent is never the aggressor. Each of the large number of traditional patterns commences with a defensive action. Named mainly after prominent Korean warriors and philosophers, the patterns have been developed over the centuries. Each one is a preset chain of movements which are an expression of the martial artist's technique, coordination, and control. Alternatively, the power of the art is probably best demonstrated in its breaking or destruction facet. This shows the sort of impact a well-executed jumping sidekick can have on an attacker. In much the same way, the demolition of this stack of clay tiles offers proof of the effectiveness of the punching action.
Okay, ready?
Okay.
Of course, some exponents have their own variations on the theme. Precision sparring at this level is something rarely viewed. Any one of these blows could be devastating, let alone the combinations artfully executed by the master and two of his senior instructors. In recent years, some Oriental martial arts have adopted point-scoring fighting competitions with exponents wearing protective equipment to allow full contact. It's a trend which has been opposed by Mr. Rhee, who upholds the traditions of his style. The master insists it will remain an art and won't allow it to become simply another sport. After all, the expansion of the art is his lifelong commitment.